The other strategy used by the media to malign Islam is they quote many verses of the Quran out of context. And one of the most common verses quoted by the critics of Islam is Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, verse number 5, which says, wherever you find a kafir, you kill him. And if you open the Quran, that verse is there. The translation is there. Wherever you find a kafir, you kill him. But it is out of context. They quote verses of the Quran out of context. They quote hadiths out of context. The context is, when we start a few verses before, it's mentioned that there was a peace treaty between the Muslims and the mushriks of Makkah. And this peace treaty was unilaterally broken by the mushriks of Makkah. By the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reaches verse number 5 of Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, He is giving an ultimatum to the mushriks of Makkah that you put things straight in 4 months' time, otherwise a declaration of war. And in the battlefield, Allah says to the Muslims that don't get scared, fight. Wherever you find the enemy, you kill him. Now, any army general, to boost up the morale of his soldiers, he will but naturally say that wherever you find the enemy, you kill him. He will not say that wherever you find the enemy, be killed. So this is in context in the battlefield. In the battlefield, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling, wherever you find the kafir, the enemy is attacking you, don't get scared, fight and kill them wherever you find them. Imagine today, if there's a war going on between America and Vietnam, and the American president says, in the battlefield, he is boosting the morale of the American soldiers, or the Army General of America says, that wherever you find a Vietnamese, you kill him. It's in context. But if I quote out of context and say, today the American president is saying that wherever you find a Vietnamese, kill him, I will make him sound like a butcher. It is out of context. And throughout the world, either they put a full stop or they jump to the next verse. And Arun Shuri, who is one of the staunchest critics of India, where I come from, he writes in his book, The World of Fatwas, after quoting verse number 5 of Surah Tawbah, he jumps on to verse number 7. You know why? Because verse number 6 has the reply to his problem. Verse number 6 of Surah Tawbah says that if the kafir, if the enemy seek asylum, don't just let them go. It says, escort him to a place of security so that he may hear the word of Allah. The most merciful army general today in the battlefield will say, if the enemy wants to go, just let him go. But the Quran doesn't say. Quran says, if the enemy wants peace, don't just let him go, escort him to a place of security. And all the verses, almost all the verses, if you read in the Quran, which talk about fighting, mostly in the battlefield, or against oppression, against tyranny, the next verse that follows is, peace is better. Always. Because Islam is a religion of peace. The third strategy used by the media to malign Islam is, they give a wrong meaning of the verses they quote, either of the Quran or the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. The fourth strategy, they quote things which are alien to Islam. It doesn't exist in Islam, but they attribute it to Islam.